If you guys have seen a positive video review on an All Powers power station, you can probably bet that the person that made that video was paid to do so. Here at the lab, we are dedicated to giving honest and truthful opinions and feedback about products, regardless of if there's money involved. And just to clarify, even though it's actually nobody's business, that doesn't mean we don't get paid. We actually got money for the last All Powers video that we made, where we took a giant sky dump on the product saying that nobody should be buying it.
All Powers website is just riddled with lies. They are just misleading people left, right, and center.
Getting paid is okay. We can't all do this shit for free. That's just the truth. Everybody knows that, but there's ways to do it and keep your integrity intact, because you're kind of just misleading your audience and misrepresenting a product that you know deep down is shit, just saying. Anyways, back on topic, we reviewed the All Powers R1500, which is this guy's little brother, not too long ago. It overheated, it had a ton of problems. We basically just said, don't go near it. And after we posted that video, All Powers responded by asking us to join their affiliate program and then asking us if we wanted to review this power station. We took that as, hey, they made a product that's probably better than this one that we just took a dump on. We'll let them redeem themselves, you know, we'll give it a try and see what happens. Unfortunately for All Powers, it didn't work out that well. So that's how we got right here. So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. Instead of doing a regular review today, we're gonna go ahead and tell you why you need to stop keeping companies like this in business. So the biggest problem that you'll find with a power station like this, or anything else that isn't like a name brand power station and doesn't have a great reputation, is that it's so easy to just lie on a website and inflate specs and make things seem one way and sell it to someone like you guys who doesn't have a full understanding of how it's supposed to work, and you might just think that that is the way it is. We've said this many times, but even name brand companies inflate specs on their website, and then when you get the unit, it's not gonna do what they say it is. But companies like All Powers have kind of taken that to an extreme. A couple of examples. This unit says it has Wi-Fi and an app. This one says right there in the manual, you hold the DC inverter button to bring the Wi-Fi on. So if we just show you right now, if you hold this button for 3 seconds, like it says, we don't get Wi-Fi. We get nothing. Where's the Wi-Fi? No Wi-Fi. That's one example. It says this unit charges at 1500 watts. It doesn't. We charged it from 0 to 100 and it never passed 1020 watts max. It says it has a 2500 watt inverter, but that's not accurate because it's not putting out 120 volts. So when we run a 1500 watt heat gun, you can see it actually shows up on the screen as about 1250. So it's making you believe it can do more than it can because it's not actually giving full power to your devices. If you have like computer equipment or something that actually demands 120 volts to be coming out of a device, this thing is not gonna be nice to it. On the surface, a unit like this is gonna look like a good deal. It's gonna be more competitive and perform just as well as the competition. But in reality, you're still spending a good chunk of money. And once you get this, and then you recognize all the problems that we just mentioned a few of, you realize it's too late, and you're basically stuck with this thing. And the misleading specs kind of bleeds into the second problem with units like this, is that they just use shitty components. There's no real R&D put into these things at all. What they're basically trying to do is just slap something together that works, make a quick buck, and then do whatever they do next. What we're saying is this thing is a house of cards and there's tons of corners cut. And a great example of that was shown in our last All Powers video, where the R1500 overheats every single time you use it, or you try to use it from 100 to 0%, like you're just using it. At about 20%, the thing's already overheated and shut off. The fans don't circulate enough air. They're not a good quality fan. Even the efficiency, we were able to get this thing to not overheat. We ran it at a certain load range with an air conditioner pointed at it the entire time. And it went from 100 to 0%. With the load it was running, it should have lasted 49 minutes. It actually lasted 29 minutes, which makes this thing 60% efficient, which is terrible even by standards of cheap products. So what that just means is if this is 2000 watts and you're trying to run a 1000 watt load, it should last 2 hours. This thing's only gonna last a little over an hour. In reality, if you're not a company that's someone like Anker or EcoFlow putting R&D into your products, someone like EG4 who actually takes things in-house, tests them, changes things, gets them redesigned, and puts time and effort into the product that they're gonna sell to the customer, you're probably not gonna get something that works very well because no one's actually really cared or played with it. And like we've talked about 100 times, When you call a company, for example, like EG4, you call Signature Solar, you get someone from Texas who can help you with your question.
Solar, this is, how can I help you?
Hey, how's it going?
I'm good, how are you?
When you call not those companies, if they have a phone number at all, usually you get something like this. And it's extremely dissatisfying when you've just spent a chunk of change on a product and now you're just, I just want to know how to turn on the Wi-Fi. Good luck. And that is our third main point and problem with even AllPowers, for example. They have a bunch of reviews on their website that say great things. If you know anything about reviews, you can kind of tell that they were paid. Maybe they're not paid. That might not be the right word. It's fake. Like, they're just not real reviews. It's someone with like 40 Gmail accounts just putting reviews there. Because if you go on Amazon, you get the real truth. Amazon's reviews of a power station like this are terrible. People saying they can't get a hold of customer service. The thing broke the second they got it out of the box. This doesn't work. That doesn't work. They haven't been able to reach anyone. It's just a matter of doing a little bit of research and realizing like, oh, hey, if I don't look on just the product's website, but I look somewhere else, I see the bigger picture here. There's also places like Trustpilot where you have to prove that you're a verified purchaser of whatever product you're trying to review. Then they let you post your review and the brand has no control. You look up AllPowers on Trustpilot, they're a 1.6 star company. And again, we're not trying to shit on just AllPowers. There's a ton of companies like this. We're trying to get you guys to kind of like think, do a little bit more research when you're like, oh, I could save $500 by buying this thing. No, you're actually losing money because every dollar you spent on it is a waste. There's a reason name brand companies are name brand. And honestly, what makes us the most upset is that there is people making videos on any of these power stations saying, hey, they're good quality, I would recommend this, lying to their viewers and their audience. If you're taking money from a company to then give them a product review that puts them in a good light because they gave you money to do so, grow some fucking balls, because there is morally correct ways to make money in this world, and that is not one of them. There's so much shady shit going on in this industry already with door-to-door salespeople and just people getting scammed from day one. And now the place where people go on the internet where they're supposed to be able to find trusted true reviews is not that, and it's so frustrating. Anyways, hey, there, do some research. Make sure you trust in people that can be trusted, and just don't buy shit because it's gonna save you $500, because the reality is it just lost you $2,000. Because you still paid for it and it sucks. So I don't know, that's it, I ranted. All right, have a great day, peace out, stay charged, don't get scammed, and for God's sake, quit promoting companies that suck.